everybody. How are you? Thank you for staying late for us. We appreciate it. Everybody here? I don't think I need my glasses. This is big tight. Everybody here? Get over here. Good. Good afternoon, everyone. And really, I really do appreciate, we all appreciate your staying here late for us this afternoon on a rainy Friday. The DPRK's January 30th launch of an intermediate range ballistic missile is a significant escalation in the DPRK's recent violations of multiple Security Council resolutions and seeks to further destabilize the region. We condemn this unlawful action in the strongest terms. The IRBM marks the regime's longest range tests since late 2017. It also marks a new and troubling record. The 9 ballistic missiles launched in January is the largest number of launches the DPRK has conducted in a single month in the history of its WMD and ballistic missiles program. We also welcome the Secretary General's statement on Tuesday, which condemned the DPRK's IRBM launch as a clear violation of Security Council resolutions. We call on all council members to speak with one voice in condemning these dangerous and unlawful acts. Albania, Brazil, France, Ireland, Japan, Norway, the United Arab Emirates, the United Kingdom, and the United States have been clear and unequivocal in expressing concern over the DPRK's continued Security Council violations and its alarming behavior. The cost of the Council's ongoing silence is too high. It will embolden the DPRK to further defy the international community, to normalize its violations of Security Council resolutions, to further destabilize the region, and to continue to threaten international peace and security. This is an outcome that we should not accept. We urge all member states, and particularly our fellow council members, to play a constructive role in the implementation of Security Council resolutions addressing the DPRK, which obligate the DPRK to abandon its weapons of mass destruction and ballistic missiles programs in a complete, verifiable, and irreversible manner. The international sanctions regime is an important tool for addressing the threat posed by the DPRK's unlawful WMD and ballistic missiles program. We reiterate our call for the DPRK to cease its destabilizing actions and return to dialogue. We remain committed to seeking serious and sustained diplomacy. The DPRK must make this same commitment in order to ease regional tensions and to ensure international peace and security. We continue to urge the DPRK to respond positively to the offers from the United States and others to meet without preconditions. We stand ready to engage in dialogue, and we will not waver in our pursuit of regional peace and security and the complete denuclearization of the Korean Peninsula consistent with relevant Security Council resolutions. Thank you.
Ambassador, your Chinese colleague said that the U.S. needs to do more. And he specifically referred to the Hanoi summit and the Singapore summit, which President Trump had with the Supreme Leader Kim. So is it time for President Biden to get directly involved in the diplomacy?
The United States has made clear that we are willing to meet with the North Koreans without preconditions. But before we can commit our president to meeting, we need to have a better sense of what there is to achieve. I can't comment on what the Trump administration achieved. We had ballistic missiles testing throughout the past 4 years. It never stopped him. So we have to keep up the pressure.
But if they engage, it could lead to a meeting with President Biden. If the North Koreans engage in diplomacy, that is something you're not ruling out.
If the conditions are there, certainly we would look at that. But we right now are in a situation where we've not been able to bring them to the diplomatic table for any discussions whatsoever.
Ambassador, is there any talk of the resolution that China and Russia tabled on freeze for freeze, is it in any way feasible up for
that grant? Resolution rewards the DPRK for bad behavior. And there's no reason for this council to reward them for nine tests in 1 month. And almost as many in the previous year. They have not earned that. We care about the humanitarian situation on the ground there. We have worked to provide humanitarian support in every way possible, but to spend millions of dollars on military tests when your people are starving, I think indicates that this country does not care about its own people.
Thank you.
Thank you, Ambassador. Have a nice weekend.
We are still working on that. We were told that the Chinese have sent the statement to Beijing. I think you spoke to him, so you heard that today.
Thank you.